In this video, we'll look at how to do a frame-by-frame animation in Adobe Animate. And we'll also look at something called motion tweens. To follow along with this video, you'll need to create a new HTML5 canvas or an ActionScript 3.0 project. And you'll need to import frames 1 through 8 of the horse animation. If you did it correctly, you'll see them in your library. Before we start animating, we're going to create something called a symbol. A symbol is a way to organize our animation. So let's go ahead and create a symbol and you'll see how it works. To do this, go to the Insert menu and choose New Symbol. You can also use the shortcut Control F8 on Windows or Command F8 on a Mac. Let's name it horse. For now, make sure the type is a movie clip. Click OK. And now, if we click over to the Library tab, you'll see the horse symbol we just created. It's the one with the little gear icon on it. The library is a place that we can create the different assets we're going to use in our animations. Notice something else. The main canvas, also called the stage, has changed. What happened is we are now inside the horse symbol. So anything we draw here is part of the symbol, not scene one. Symbols also have their own timeline. So when we're inside the horse symbol, the timeline down here is only for the symbol. If I want to get out of the symbol, I can just click here where it says scene one. And now the timeline below is for scene one. But we're going to do our frame-by-frame animation inside the horse symbol. So to get back inside, all you need to do is double-click on the horse symbol in the library. So now we're back inside the horse symbol. Now, how do we animate the horse? Well, we need some keyframes. But this time we're going to do a frame-by-frame animation. This means we have to create every frame of the animation. There are no tweens. So that means every frame needs to be a keyframe. It may sound difficult, but it's actually pretty simple. Let's take a look. To start out, go to the library and drag horseframe1.png onto the symbols drawing area. Now, when you're doing frame-by-frame animation, it's important that all your frames line up exactly. Otherwise, your animation will jump around and won't look right. To do this, click on the horse, then go to the Properties tab, and where it says Position and Size, set both X and Y to 0. In graphic programs, X and Y are position coordinates. X is horizontal, left and right. And Y is vertical, up and down. So we've set them to 0. Next, click on frame 2 on the symbol timeline and hit F6 to insert a new keyframe. Now that we're on frame 2, select and delete the horse from the drawing area. You can just press the delete key on your keyboard. Then go back to the library and drag frame 2 onto the drawing area. Make sure both X and Y are 0. Then click on frame 3 in the symbol timeline. Hit F6 to create a keyframe, then delete the horse. And then drag frame 3 onto the drawing area. Set X and Y to 0. And do the same for each of the frames until you get through frame 8. I'll go ahead and do the rest of them now. So now, if you press the play button on the symbol timeline, you'll see that we have a smooth animation. Let's go back to the main stage for scene 1. So our stage is still empty. The animation is completely contained inside the symbol. We can actually preview it in the library. Select horse, and then go up here and press the play button. Now, to use this animation, just drag the horse symbol onto the stage. Let's test it. Go to Control and choose Test. And then we get a preview in our browser window, and we can see that we have a nice running horse. The nice thing about symbols is that they can be reused. So I can drag another horse onto the stage if I want. Preview again, Control Test. And now we have two horses with no additional work. One more thing. Wouldn't it be nice if we could get the horses to run across the stage? Let's delete the second horse for now. And then let's drag the horse to the left so he starts off stage. Notice that the scene 1 timeline is currently on frame 1, and the little black dot tells us that it already has a keyframe on it. Now right-click on frame 1 and choose Create Motion Tween. Notice that the first 24 frames of the timeline have turned blue. Also, the timeline cursor has jumped to frame 24. Next, click on the horse and drag him to the other side of the stage. When you let go of the mouse button, two things happen. A blue line shows up on the drawing area, This shows the path of our moving object. The second thing is that Animate automatically adds a keyframe to frame 24. Control test again. And now we have a looping animation of a horse that runs across the screen. You can tweak it some more. Click any of the points on the motion path and drag. And now my horse does a flying leap.